الحمد لله نحمده سبحانه ونستعينه ونستغفره ونستهديه ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهد الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، ولا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله العلي العظيم. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله وصفوته من خلقه وحبيبه، قد بلغ الرسالة وأدى الأمانة وكشف الغمة وجاهد من أجل الأمة وجاهد في سبيل الله حتى أتاه اليقين. فاللهم اجزه عنا وعن والدينا وعن الإسلام والمسلمين خير ما جزيت به نبيا عن قومه ورسولا عن أمته. اللهم أحينا على سنته وأمتنا على ملته، واحشرنا تحت لوائه وأوردنا حوضه، واسقنا من يده الشريفة شربة هنيئة لا نظمأ بعدها أبدا. أما بعد، we are going to continue the coverage of the issue of the practicality of the Quran in our life, how the Quran explains what is going on in our life and what he tells us to do to manage our life in a way that is pleasing to Allah and is better for our interest. We are using Surah Al-Isra or portions thereof to cover this topic. We finished with ayah number 15 and we are continuing with ayah number 16. In ayah number 15, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us, من اهتدى فإنما يهتدي لنفسه. He who follows the guidance, he is guided for his own best interest. And he who goes astray, he is going astray to his own detriment. These two choices are given to us from the beginning of our creation. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَهَدَيْنَاهُ النَّجْدَيْنَ. We have guided him to the two paths, the path of paradise, the path of righteousness, the path of goodness, and the path of evil and wickedness. And the result is what you plan for yourself. So the choice you make as to how you lead your life definitely will determine where you go. It is like the highway you take and the direction you follow will lead you certainly to certain places. It cannot be based on our wishes. I cannot drive on 95 south and wish to get to New York. New York is 95 north. No matter how much I wish I go to New York, I'm driving towards Florida. So New York is not going to show on the map unless I'm driving north. So that's why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran, لَيْسَ بِأَمَانِيِّكُمْ وَلَا أَمَانِيِّ أَهْلِ الْكِتَابِ. It is not up to your wishful thinking or the wishful thinking of the people of the book. It is not a competition as to who claims to be more righteous. It is about practice. It is about correct faith, correct direction, correct action. This is what huda and guidance is about. وَلَا تَزِرُ وَازِرَةٌ وِزْرَ أُخْرَى. No sinful soul will carry the burden of another sinful soul. وَمَا كُنَّا مُعَذِّبِينَ حَتَّى نَبْعَثَ رَسُولًا. We would never put to punishment or torment until and unless we had sent a messenger. A messenger does not have to be a physical person that we call a prophet or a messenger divinely sent by Allah to do something. We all get messengers all the time in the form of messages that Allah makes us hear or see or witness or experience in our life. When you do something good, you feel the blessings in your life. When you do something wrong, you know it in your heart and you feel that what you have done is regrettable and sinful. So these are messages. These are messages. And the messenger there is yourself. It is yourself. This will be the witness against you or for you on the day of judgment. Then the next ayah comes to explain a godly law, a divine law. The divine law says, and it comes in Surah Al-Imran, وَتِلْكَ الْأَيَّامُ نُدَاوِلُهَا بَيْنَ النَّاسِ. And those days we do recycle amongst people. So nobody stays in the most powerful position forever. And nobody stays weak forever. No land stays green forever. No land stays to be desert forever. Everything is changing, whether we recognize it or not. Some things take longer time than others, but everything is changing. Then it explains also another law. How much do we have to affect the change in what happens? So Allah says, إن الله لا يغير ما بقوم حتى يغيروا ما بأنفسهم. Allah would not change the conditions of a people or community unless and until they change what is in themselves. So we have to figure out what is in ourselves that we need to change. This is a constant topic that we talk about because it is the topic of every minute, every day, every second in our life. So here, ayah 16, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying, وَإِذَا أَرَدْنَا أَن نُهْلِكَ قَرْيَةً. And if we wanted to destroy a town, or a city, or a village, أَمَرْنَا مُتْرَفِيهَا. We commanded their luxury living elite or wealthiest, okay, those who are living a luxury, lofty life, أَمَرْنَا مُتْرَفِيهَا. It may also mean, مُتْرَفِيهَا means the people in power, the people in responsibility, because these are also powerful. So power is not only money, power is also in authority. You have the power to make a decision that can help or hurt your people. So that gives you a lot of power to influence their life. Like the example of Pharaoh, Allah gave in the Quran, we all know that. And the example of Lut, who was guiding his people to what is righteous, but their own elite, they were telling them, he is wrong, go the other way out. So now it is between those elite and their followers to correct the direction of the community. This is something very central, because when we complain that our ummah is suffering a lot, when we pray and ask Allah to correct the direction of our ummah and to give us power and to defeat our enemies, we must do our part. What is our part? Let us listen to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And when we want to destroy a community or a nation or a village or a town, we command those in charge or those in power or those who are well-to-do in this community. And then one has to ask, the ayah doesn't say, أَمَرْنَا مُتْرَفِيهَا, to do what? But the Quran explains, it's very clear. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, إِنَّ اللَّهَ يَأْمُرُ بِالْعَدْلِ. When Allah commands, He commands justice, وَالْإِحْسَانِ, and goodness and righteousness, وَإِيْتَاءِ ذِي الْقُرْبَى, and to provide for the kin and the relatives. This is what Allah commands. So the command is not explicitly mentioned here because it's mentioned somewhere else what Allah commands. In Surah Al-A'raf, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, قُلْ أَمَرَ رَبِّي بِالْقِسْطِ. Allah commanded justice as it should be. Justice as it should be, not as we think it may be. Not as we think how much justice should we dispense for a community or a people that we lead. Justice is a concept that comes from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He is the just one. Huwa al-hakam al-adl subhanahu wa ta'ala. Then as Allah commands the elite to do justice and to look after the weak and the vulnerable and the poor and the needy, then فَفَسَقُوا فِيهَا. Then they disobey. They go against Allah's commands. Then whose responsibility is it to correct the direction of the elite in the community, vis-a-vis the interests of the community. It is on the community. It is in the community. Allah will not send angels to correct everybody physically. Allah sent revelations and gave us the freedom to choose. And if we, the community, choose to accept the disobedience of our leaders, those who govern our nations and communities, then the choice is all ours. It is either for us or against us. So Allah is definitely telling us the good is for you and the bad is on you. As He says here, وَلَا تَزِرُ وَازِرَةٌ وِزْرَ أُخْرَى مَنِ اهْتَدَى فَإِنَّمَا يَهْتَدِي لِنَفْسِهِ, which also means that it is not enough for an individual to be righteous. Being righteous is definitely required, but as in math, they say it is necessary but not sufficient. It is not enough that you are righteous. You have to be a reformer. Only reformers are going to be saved when the punishment of Allah comes. Allah says, وَاتَّقُوا فِتْنَةً لَا تُصِيبَنَّ الَّذِينَ ظَلَمُوا مِنْكُمْ خَاصَّةً. So we have those who have committed wrongdoing and injustice, and we have the rest of the community are righteous, but they are not correcting anything. They are not standing against any evil. So why shouldn't evil cover them as well? Zainab bint Jahsh, رضي الله عنها وارضاها, the wife of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, asked him once, أَنَهْلَكُ وَفِينَ الصَّالِحُونَ, could we ever perish and be put to punishment even though we have righteous people amongst us? He says, yes, إِذَا كَثُرَ الْخَبَثُ, when evil is prevalent, yes, the righteous and the good and the evil and the bad will all perish together. It's one ship, as it is described in the hadith of the Prophet. If we do not stop those who are destroying the ship will sink and nobody will be saved. Nobody will be saved. So this is a lesson that the Quran is telling us. There is a law that controls how things evolve. They do not all of a sudden change by heavenly intervention. But if it is a punishment, they do. When Allah gives up on a community that it is ever going to be correcting by itself, He destroys it. We have this example in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala telling us in the story of Nuh in Surah Hud, that وَأُوحِيَ إِلَى نُوحٍ أَنَّهُ لَنْ يُؤْمِنَ مِنْ قَوْمِكَ إِلَّا مَنْ قَدْ آمَنَ. Revelation was then given to Nuh that no one is going to correct, no one is going to believe anymore than the ones who already believed. So make the ship. فَصْنَعِ الْفُلْكَ بِأَعْيُنِنَا وَوَحْيِنَا. So Allah decides when is the time for allowing opportunities and when is the time to finish and end the allowance He gives. The time is His. But listen to this. The punishment doesn't always have to be a catastrophic, out-of-hand crisis. It could be. We have seen it with Nuh's people. We have seen it with Lot's people. We have seen it with Shu'aib, Ba'ad, and Thamud, and other communities. But it could also be that Allah would send our enemies against us. مروا بالمعروف وانهوا عن المنكر أو ليوشكن الله أن يبعث عليكم عذابا من عنده. Enjoin the good and forbid the evil. Otherwise, Allah is about to send torment from His upon you. This is a threat. This is a threat and a warning. So we have to be careful not to abandon what many Muslim scholars have called the sixth pillar of Islam, which is enjoining the good and forbidding the evil. Al-amr bil-ma'ruf wal-nahi an al-munkar has been listed as the number six pillar of Islam. We know the five pillars. They say amr bil-ma'ruf and nahi an al-munkar is the pillar number six. For Islam to be effective in our life, we have to apply it, we have to live it. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala guide us to live as Muslims and to make Islam the guiding source and the guiding power in our life and decisions. الحمد لله وكفى والصلاة والسلام على عباده الذين اصطفى وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله وبعد. So then you read the next ayah. وكم أهلكنا من القرون من بعد نوح. And how many generations, how many nations, how many communities have we destroyed after Nuh? It's a remarkable statement. So that we don't think that the only catastrophe that took a community is, you know, the flood of Noah. No, it is just one catastrophe. But there are many other communities I just mentioned that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is here referring to tell us, don't ignore my signs will keep coming. It is up to you to pick it. It's up to you to pick it up and take notice. When Allah floods the whole world with a small, very small virus. You know, in this past Sunday's class, to our children, one child about 8-9 years old was asking, how would Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala destroy Gog and Magog? How they will be destroyed? And I said, Allah will send, according to the hadith, a very small, tiny creature that will kill them. And he said, how? I said, it is similar to the coronavirus. Because in the description of the hadith, it will get into their nose and it will cause them death. Is Allah treating us like Gog and Magog? Could it be? Should we ask the question, or is this an illegitimate question? It is a legitimate question. So Allah is always showing us signs and giving us signals. If we do not read the signs, if we do not follow the signals, we are going to go astray and think we are doing very well. As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala describes in Surah Al-Kahf, قُلْ هَلْ أُنَبِّئُكُمْ بالأخسرين أعمالا. Should I tell you about those who are most in loss as far as their deeds are concerned? الذين ضل سعيهم في الحياة الدنيا. Those whose walking on earth has gone astray. وهم يحسبون أنهم يحسنون صنعا. They think they are doing very well. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala save us and save our ummah from all catastrophes and all harm. Allahumma ihdina fi man hadayt, wa afina fi man afayt, wa tawallana fi man tawallayt, wa qina wasrif anna sharra ma qadayt. Allahumma aqsim lana min khashyatika ma tahulu bi baynana wa bayna ma'siyatik, wa min ta'atika ma tuballighuna bi jannatak, wa min al-yaqin ma tuhawwinu bi alayna masa'ib ad-dunya. Wa matti'na Allahumma bi asma'ina وأبصارنا وقوتنا ما أحييتنا واجعله الوارث منا واجعل ثأرنا على من ظلمنا ولا تجعل مصيبتنا في ديننا ولا تجعل الدنيا أكبر همنا ولا مبلغ علمنا ولا إلى النار مصيرنا. وإذا أردت بقومنا فتنة فنجنا منها يا مولانا غير خزايا ولا مفتونين ولا مبدلين ولا مغيرين. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولكم فستذكرون ما أقول لكم وأفوض أمري إلى الله إن الله بصير بالعباد. وأقم الصلاة.